गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
मैम हेलो मैम मैम आई थिंक स्टूडेंट्स आर वेटिंग इन द वेटिंग रूम। कैन यू जस्ट एडमिट देम। शिरीषा मैम आर यू देयर?
या आई गॉट इट।
ओके ओके मैम। या
Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
How you wrote your exam?
Good morning, ma'am.
Ma'am, well, ma'am.
Super.
Yes, ma'am.
Huh? How you wrote your exam?
Good, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Ma'am.
So let us first discuss the paper, yesterday's exam. Only multiple choice we'll discuss, then we'll start off with the new chapter. Okay. You want me to discuss or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
1 minute. So I'm sharing the screen. So you're able to see all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, now you tell me the development of a seedling from an embryo at under appropriate condition is called?
Germination.
Germination.
How many got correct?
I got correct.
Site of fertilization in mammals.
Fallopian tube.
Fallopian tube.
Good. Which of the following have buds on their leaves?
Bryophyllum.
Bryophyllum.
Okay, very good. Semiferous tubules are composed of?
Germinal epithelium.
Germinal epithelium.
Spermatogonia.
No. Epithelium, no germinal is there. Glandular epithelium. Okay. Spermatogonia is not present in semiferous tubules. When such a type of a question is coming, you need to rule out. Okay. Say epithelium is only few cubical, glandular, like that only will be present. I think so. You studied your tissues in the 9th class.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You studied anywhere senescence and germinal?
Oh, ma'am.
Spermatogonia, we know that it is not there in the semiferous tubules. Only it supplies lubricant. So what will be the ultimate answer?
Glandular.
That is the way how you need to rule out when such a type of questions comes. I know by when I'm giving this question only, I know how many will answer or not. So I want you all to try. Next one also, similar pattern. Cowpeas glands are present in where?
Male mammals.
Correct. Next one. This one. The diagram. Only few are answering. I'm not able to see here other answers. So many are there in the online today. The diagram that shows the cross section. So what is the correct answer?
Ma'am, option D.
D, ma'am.
Option?
D.
D.
How many of you got correct this one?
Ma'am, me.
Me also, ma'am.
Only three? Okay, I'll correct the papers today or tomorrow. I will know. The vegetative reproduction in the root. Sweet potato.
Root, ma'am.
Root.
Root,
ma'am.
Ovulation in female human beings.
40 to 45 years, ma'am.
40 years.
Moli Niranjan is answering.
Ma'am, 45 to 50 years.
Ma'am, 50 years, ma'am.
50 years, ma'am.
Niranjan, stop answering. Let us other people answer. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Fuchsia shoot hidden in the seed is called.
Lumule.
Now tell me this assertion and reasoning. Vasectomy, it is a surgical method for birth control. Correct. In vasectomy, small portion of oviduct is cut or tied properly.
False, ma'am.
False.
Assertion is true. Reason is true.
Reason is false.
Yes. Assertion is true. Reason is false. Vocal cords occurring.
Larynx.
In cardiac cycle, diastolis is?
Relaxation period after contraction of heart.
Yes, true. Which of the following structures is involved in gaseous exchange in woody stems?
Lenticle.
Yes. In the following changes that takes place in the athlete's body during 100 meters race, what it is?
Increasing production of carbon dioxide by muscles.
Yes, correct. How many got it correct, this one?
I got, ma'am.
I'm hearing three or four. Remaining? No sound. Major. Okay, these four, please don't talk. Whoever is talking, let the other people talk from now. Major function of contractile vacuole. Remaining people, please answer. Can you answer?
Osmoregulation.
Who is this answering?
Nirupama.
Hamsini.
Okay. Which is the correct route for the blood flow in the human beings?
Ma'am, option D.
Option D, ma'am.
What is it?
Right
atrium, right ventricle. Right ventricle,
lungs atrium, left ventricle.
Right atrium, right ventricle. Left atrium, left ventricle, lungs.
Yes, ma'am. Option B, no, ma'am.
That's what I'm asking, ma'am. But you all told right, no. First.
Ma'am, we wrote option B only, ma'am.
You wrote option B only. Left atrium, left ventricles, right atrium, right ventricles, lungs. Which one?
Ma'am, option D, ma'am.
Ah. B, ma'am.
Now tell me.
Option D, ma'am.
B, you're telling no.
D, ma'am, D.
Okay, now you tell me. Right atrium, right ventricle,
lungs.
Left atrium, left ventricle. Yes, this is correct one. The function of glomerulus and Bowman's capsule of a nephron is? What is it? Answer. What is it? Okay, you four only answer. Remaining are not answering. They just want to listen. What is option? Hello?
Filter the blood and capture the filtrate.
Filter D, option D.
D, ma'am.
Yes, option D. The movement of water and dissolved minerals from the roots of the leaves is best explained by?
Translocation.
Option B.
No, that is
A.
Definition. Movement of water explained by?
Tension theory.
Cohesion theory. Please read your question properly. Is best explained by not that translocation is a definition. It's best explained by cohesion and tension theory or section pressure theory. Any of this it comes, you need to put that one as the answer. Which of the following is not a component of the plasma?
Platelets.
Platelets.
Option A.
Dialysis unit contains a fluid which is almost same as plasma, except that what it does not contain?
Urea.
High urea.
Yes. Assertion and reason. Which one is correct?
Both A and R are correct.
Yes,
A, option A, ma'am.
Yes. Next, final one. The thin double wall sac enclosing the heart is called?
Pericardial sac.
Pericardiac sac.
Pericardium, correct. So I hope all of you answered all the questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll correct your papers and you will be knowing. So I'm now I'm stopping the screen. So today we'll be starting. You can see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, ma'am. Today we'll be starting with the new chapter, that is heredity and evolution. So in case of class 10, only heredity is present according to the new syllabus. Evolution is not there, but we are going to study the complete chapter so that it will be useful for your future in your class 11 and class 12. Okay, in class 12, you will be getting evolution as a complete chapter. This is the basic foundation for that. So, since we have a lot of time, we'll be studying the complete chapter. Okay, but your exams will be conducted only on the heredity basis. So, before going to this chapter, you need to know few important terminologies. Otherwise, you will not be able to understand the chapter properly. So please note down these terminologies. Take a book, all of you. Please take a book. So please, these are the common terminologies which we have discussed in how do organisms reproduce also in the first slide itself. So I no need to explain these. I hope all of you know it. We have discussed all already in how do organisms reproduce. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Whoever yes, don't know, who are new to the session, you can ask me if you don't know anything. I'm seeing few people in the session, new people. Anybody who does not know, you can call, talk, no problem. Okay? So the first definition is chromosome. They are thin thread-like structures present in the nucleus which carries the gene. They are mainly composed of DNA and proteins. In the last how do organisms reproduce, I have shown you all how the chromosomes look like. Okay, let me finish this, the first slide definition. Second, I will show that same picture to you all. Next, genes. Genes, these are the unit of inheritance occurring at a specific location on a chromosome. A single gene may be made up of thousands of DNA bases. Next, DNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. It consists of nucleotides and is the main constituent of the chromosome. It is the carrier of the genetic information from the parents to the offsprings. Next one, amino acids. Amino acids are the organic molecules that are nothing but the building blocks of the proteins. There are 20 different types of amino acids and they are linked by a peptide bond. Next, proteins. These are the biomacromolecules consisting of one or more chain of amino acids, performing various functions like enzymes, antibodies, hormones, and the structural components. All of you have noted down?
Ma'am, just a minute.
So that I'll stop the screen and show you all the chromosomes, genes, and DNA.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, once I'm stopping the screen. You can see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a cell. Okay, inside the cell, inside this nucleus. So this is the complete cell. Inside the nucleus, you will be seeing the chromosomes. Okay, they are tightly winded to be so that we get this. They are tightly, but this is a nucleus. Inside the nucleus, we have the chromosomes. So they are tightly winded so that we get in this shape. Okay. These chromosomes usually have two chromatids. So these chromatids are, these arms are known as chromatids. So up the chromosome has two arms on the upside, two arms on the bottom sides. So they have two chromatids on the up and two chromatids in the bottom, and they are joined by a middle part known as centromere. Okay, so this is a type, these carries, these chromosomes carries many genes. Okay, the chromosome, these are chromosomes are made up of genes. So what is this chromosome? Chromosome is nothing but a DNA. Okay, it is a, this is a DNA, a double helical structure is known as the DNA. So the DNA winds itself along with the proteins known as histones and form into a tightly compacted structure known as chromosome, because it need to be fitted into a small nucleus. And each nucleus, for example, human nucleus, human cell nucleus usually carries 46 chromosomes. Okay, so 46 chromosomes should be kept inside. Whereas what is the length of the DNA? Usually the length of DNA is around 3.6 into 10 to power of 9, means once it can, there is a saying like that, it once it can go around the globe when we unwind it properly. Okay, such a amount should be fitted into the inside a nucleus inside the cell. So if the cell or cell itself is in the usually the size of cell is usually around micrometers. So in that micrometer, inside the nucleus, the chromosomes DNA should be fitted. So usually the DNA is arranged in this compact manner, and this is known as chromosome. So these chromosomes contains the genes required for all the functions of the body, like genes which are coding for hair color, eye color, everything will be present in this chromosome itself. Okay. So these chromosomes are nothing but the DNA molecule. DNA is a double helical structure. Now coming to the proteins. So first let us finish off this DNA. So this DNA. So this DNA is made up of nucleotides. Okay. DNA is made up of nucleotides, please remember. So how it is like is, this nucleus, as last time we have discussed, if you take a flowers, okay, a jasmine flower, okay, so jasmine flower is made up of what? Your nucleotides are like a jasmine flower. So a group of nucleotides form into a DNA. Okay, a group of nucleotides are connected to form to a DNA. Again, this so we have a this is a DNA. Now this one again will be tightly coiled with the help of proteins. It will be more tightly, means it will be brought more closer in this manner. You can see it will be brought more closer so that we get some small shape or something like this. Okay, so this is how the DNA is folded to form a chromosome. So in the for folding of this DNA or packing of this DNA, we require proteins. So what are these proteins? For every cell, the proteins are nothing like a building blocks. Okay, we have the muscles are made up of proteins. Everything, whatever the biological activities which happen inside the cells require these proteins. We also study. We also know that we need to take a lot of proteins in our diet also. Okay, so what these proteins are made up of? Like DNA, DNA is made up of nucleotides. Proteins are also made up of amino acids. Proteins are also made up of amino acids. I'm writing in a short term. Proteins are also made up of amino acids. So like we have 20 different proteins are required to make 20 different amino acids are required to make these proteins. So a combination of different amino acids makes up the protein. So I hope you understood DNA is made up of what?
Proteins.
And DNA is made up of?
Nucleotides.
Proteins are made up of?
Amino acids.
Yes. I hope all of you have understood.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you, all 10 people in the session.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'm just once again exiting the video. You can see the heredity and evolution?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now we'll move on to the next points. From here, you have not learned much terminology. So next one is the allele. So what is an allele? First, let us compare with the gene and the allele. Okay, allele means different forms of the same gene. What is a gene? A gene is a portion of a DNA that determines the trait. Means it will be determining a gene can determine, means it will be expressing our hair color, our eye color, or whatever it is. But what is an allele? Allele is different, gene is different. Allele means a different form of the different forms of a gene. Like, for example, we have a black hair, red, white hair, creamy hair, brown hair, okay, red colors. So the hair can exist in different colors, can be expressed in different colors. So here it will be different forms of the genes will be expressed in different colors. So you can take an example in the bottom I am telling you. Okay, for example, for your understanding, Coca-Cola is a gene. Okay, you think the Coca-Cola is a gene. In Coca-Cola, we have different varieties of bottles. Okay, some Coke without much sugar, sugarless Coke, or high thunder Coke, or high less sweet Coke, like that. So those are the alleles. The different forms of Coke are the alleles. But gene will be expressing only the Coca-Cola. Whereas different forms of the gene are known as the alleles. Now we'll come to the biological example. So gene will be expressing the eye color, whereas alleles are the different forms of that eye color. It can be a blue eye, it can be a brown eye, or it can be a green eye. Okay, so the alleles is always represented by, for example, you take a tall plant. Okay, the height of the plant always we represent it by two forms. Always the allele will be having represented by two. Not always, but it all in general, usually the allele is represented by two alleles. Means it will be having the two forms. Okay. Later we'll be discussing what is dominant and recessive. But you understood the alleles? Always it occurs in pairs only. Okay. So the genes are responsible for the expression of the traits. Alleles are responsible for the variation which gives the trait can be expressed. Okay. Genes does not occur in pairs, whereas alleles occur in pairs. I have told you, no, they'll be always occurring in pair only. Okay. Not less than two. They will be more than two, but not less than two. Genes don't occur in pairs. Alleles occur in the pairs. So what are the examples of the gene? Gene eye color, hairline shape. Allele is blue eyes, bold hair, V-shaped hairline. So this is the difference between a gene and this is the difference between a allele. I hope all of you understood what is an allele.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I move on? You noted?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Noted.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
So now coming to the alleles. I have already told they are the alternate form of the alleles. So all we usually always there will be two alleles, but sometimes they will not be less than two. They always exist in pairs only. But in some conditions, there will be more than two alleles, like ABO blood group. Because here ABO blood group has three alleles. A, B, and O. Such a types are known as multiple alleles. A condition where a particular trait is called controlled by more than two alleles, or a condition in which the gene occurs more than two alleles, are known as multiple alleles. The best example is ABO blood group. So you can see these are the three alleles, A, B, and O. So based on this, we get all these combinations of blood. Either we can get AB, BO, AO, or O blood group. Means we get the blood group will be AB, or the blood group will be B, or the blood group will be A, or the blood group will be O. So any of this we can get in the by the combination of ABO. Okay, such a type is known as multiple allele. Next, coming to the dominant allele. Okay, so if an allele that masks the presence of a recessive allele in a phenotype, such are called as dominant alleles. So the dominant alleles for a trait are usually expressed if an individual is homozygous dominant or it may be a heterozygous. You can see this condition over here. So this gives A is the indication, is A is a dominant type. So now we have two alleles. Okay. The color is represented. The dark red, if now you have a bird over here. That A represents the red color. Whereas small a represents the blue color. So here, the capital A is a dominant one, whereas small a is a recessive one. Means, if we take in a combination of like this, A and small a, at the time also, the color of the strain will be red color only. Okay? Either if we get a combination of A and a small a, the color of the stain will be red color only. So this, in this phenomenon, a is a dominant allele, whereas small a is a recessive allele. Okay, a is a dominant allele and small a is a recessive allele. So the dominant allele can be homozygous. Homozygous means if both a and a, the both the alleles are capital A and capital A only, then as usual we'll get a dominant allele only, the dominant one. Okay, this is called as a, these are alleles are dominant, and this is called as homozygous dominant because both the alleles are A and A. Suppose now we get one capital A and one small a. At that time also the color of the stain will be red color only. But this condition is a heterozygous condition, where because one allele is a capital A, one allele is a small a. Means the capital A is a dominant allele, whereas a small a is a recessive allele. Only we get a blue color when the both the alleles are recessive only. Means both the alleles are homozygous recessive only, we get a blue color. Otherwise, we don't get the blue color. Okay, hope you understood.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
How many of you understood?
Ma'am, one doubt, ma'am.
1 minute. Tell me, ma'am.
Ma'am, what this mean by phenotype, ma'am?
I'll tell you. Next, we'll come to that.
Okay, ma'am.
I'm coming one by one. Till here, you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts till here? Please note down the definitions. Dominant allele. An allele that masks the presence of a recessive allele in a phenotype is known as a dominant allele. So the dominant allele traits can exist in a as a homozygous dominant or also in the heterozygous condition. Next, coming to the recessive allele. A allele which expression is masked by the presence of a dominant allele is called as a recessive allele. Recessive alleles can be expressed only when it is in a homozygous recessive condition. Next, heterozygous. A genotype consisting of two different types of alleles, that is capital A and a small a condition, is known as heterozygous condition. Next, homozygous condition. A genotype consisting of same type of a alle for a gene, that is either capital A or small a, smaller a, This is known as a homozygous condition. If there is a capital A, it is known as homozygous dominant. If there is a small a, it is known as a homozygous recessive. All of you have copied these definitions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I move on to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, in that multiple allele, so if we take an example of blood group A1 positive, will that come under multiple allele?
No. What here we are telling is the blood group, the trait blood group is controlled by three alleles.
Okay, ma'am.
A, B, and O.
Okay, ma'am.
So the based on the combination of these three, means whatever the allele, whatever we get based on that, we'll get the blood group. Either A, it can either be B, or sometimes we may get AB also. And sometimes only O also we may get.
Okay, ma'am.
But that trait is controlled by three variations. For example, if we take, here we discussed only two alleles.
Yes,
but ma'am. There will be three alleles.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now coming to the genotype and phenotype. The genetic makeup of an individual is known as a genotype. Genotype is a combination of alleles on an organism inherits from its parents. The genes are known as genotype. Okay. Next, coming to the phenotype. the observable characteristics of a organism that are a result of the expression of a genotype are known as phenotypes. So the appearance, whatever the appearance which we can see physically with our eyes, that is known as a phenotype. For example, hair color. I have given you the example. Okay, so the hair is what type of a hair we have, whether we have a straight hair or curly hair. We can see with our eyes that we have a straight hair. That is known as a phenotype. Whereas coming to the genotype, the hair, straight hair can be expressed as WW or it can be expressed as capital W and small w. It can be a homozygous dominant or it can be a heterozygous. So that is a genotype. Okay, what we see is the phenotype. The genes indicates or the alleles indicates the genotype which are present in our coding, in our DNA. Whereas what we can see with our visual eyes is known as the phenotype. Hope you got it, Niranjan.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts still here for everybody?
No doubts, ma'am.
Next, no, ma'am. Hybrid. A offspring of a cross between two genetically different parents is known as a hybrid. So in case now we are hearing about the different, like what we can say a hybrid, a combination between a red rose and a white rose. We may get something other thing. We may get a pink rose or we can get a combination of both. So this the whatever the offspring we get, we call it as a hybrid. Okay. Next one, F1 generation. The first generation of the offsprings, when two parents mate, and when we get the offspring, the first generation is known as the F1 generation or filial generation. Okay. When two parents mate, and we get an offspring, such a cross between two parents, and the when we get the offsprings, offsprings are nothing but the daughter or of sons, means children. Offsprings, so here we don't call children, we call it as offspring. Okay, the first generation is known as the filial, F1 generation or the filial generation. The subsequent, next, if the offsprings are crossed or mated, then we get a second generation, third generation, fourth generation. They are referred as F2, F3, F4 and goes on. Okay. Next, that we'll be studying well in the Mendelian laws in this chapter. Next, in the Punnett square, that diagram that represents the outcome of the particular cross is known as a Punnett square, like this. If we represent in a form of a box, we call it as a Punnett square. I have represented it in ABO blood group. So such a type of representation is known as the Punnett square. Next, codominance. The situation where neither the allele is dominant or recessive, both of them appear in the phenotype. Such a one is called as codominance. I'll explain your first note on the definition. Next, incomplete dominance. The situation where the phenotypic expression of one allele for a specific trait is not completely expressed over the other allele, then we get an intermediate trait. Such a type is known as the incomplete dominance. For example, you can see over here, we have two alleles. What is that? One is dominant one, that is B. One is a recessive one. We always think, because it is a heterozygous, this may be a recessive one. Why? But so in a complete dominance, usually in a normal condition, only we get the B one express. That is the B. So we get a blue color only. But in case of codominance, both the alleles are dominant. So both the alleles are expressed. B color is expressed, blue color is expressed, as well as the yellow color also is expressed. That is called as codominance. Whereas in case of incomplete dominance, neither the blue is expressed Now the yellow is expressed. We got an intermediate, something, a different color is got. That is called as an incomplete dominance. Neither of the alleles have been expressed properly. So we got an intermediate color, that is the yellow. Also, we can take another example for this. Suppose I cross a red flower and a white flower. So here we get one, both the red characteristics of a flower as well as the white characteristics of a flower. If you take this a flower, here red is present as well as white is present in the petals. Nowadays we are getting, no, you can see the hybrid flowers. But in any in incomplete dominance, altogether we get a pink flower. When we cross a white and a red flower, we get a pink flower. Such is known as the incomplete dominance. Hope you understood.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So now please note these definitions. Now this is regarding the evolution part. Till here we have studied about the heredity part. Now with these definitions are regarding the evolution part. Please note these definitions. Evolution, genetic changes that are accumulated in a population over time that might lead to speciation, that is formation of new species. Speciation is called as formation of new species, is known as evolution. Next, gene flow. The transfer of genes from one population to another population by migration, for possibly leading to altered gene frequency, is known as gene flow. I'll explain when we are talking about the evolution, because these should be explained with the examples, which will take a lot of time. There again, we will study about it. Now, please note down the definitions. Now, gene pool. The sum of total of all different alleles in a population at a given time is known as a gene pool. Genetic drift. Random change in gene frequencies of a small population that produce diversity without any survival advantage is called as a genetic drift. Mutations. A change in DNA at a particular location in the chromosome of an organism is called as mutations. Karyotype. A photo captured through a microscope of all the chromosomes in a person is known as karyotype. The chromosomes are arranged from chromosome 1 to chromosome 23. Means karyotype means the number of chromosomes which are present. When we see, visualize it under the microscope, we can see all the 23 chromosomes. That is known as karyotypic arrangement of the chromosomes. So with this, we have completed the terminologies required for this chapter, heredity and evolution. Now let us go for a brief introduction. In the next class, we'll be talking about the Mendelian's principles. Okay, so what is heredity? The transfer of characters or strains from parents to their offsprings is called as heredity. So when the transfer of characters are, we call them as traits also. The characters means eye color, blue, hair color, height of the person, everything, all these characters, color of the skin, all these are the characters or the traits. All these traits we get from our parents. So they will be the DNA which is transformed from there, from the parents to offsprings will be carrying all these characters. So the transfer of these characters or traits from the parents to their offsprings is called as heredity. So what the difference between the characters or traits among the individuals of the same species is also called as variations. Means there will be a variations and between the progeny, between the parents and their offsprings, also between the offsprings also will be having the variations. So such a differences between the differences where there will be a difference in the existence of the traits and characters and traits are called as variations. For example, now if is you have a straight hair, okay? But your mother may be having a curly hair, okay? That is a variation you will be seeing from your mother to you. Whereas if you have a brother or a sister, your brother or sister may be having a curly hair, okay? But you will be, or you are having a straight hair. This is a variation you see among your offsprings also. Means among your siblings also. You see among your with your siblings. So such a way, so such a character difference of characters or traits is called as variation. We have studied about this in your how do organisms reproduce also. But please take the definitions. Here also we'll be getting questions on variations. So coming to the accumulation of variation during the reproduction. Why do variations first give a result? Okay, when organisms reproduce, the offspring shows a minor variation due to inaccuracies in DNA copying. So only we get the variations. So these variations are less in asexual reproduction, but more in sexual reproduction. So due to inaccuracies in DNA copying and sometimes due to mutations, due to external environment, sometimes the DNA may be damaged also. So due to change or damage in the DNA due to external factors is called as mutations. So sometimes due to mutations also, we get these variations. So the variations are, as we discussed in the previous chapter, they are very less in asexual reproduction, but they are way more in the sexual reproduction. So such variations are useful, which some variation means the, all the variations we get are not useful for us. Okay, only the some variations are useful for us. Okay, so these variations help us to adjust to the changing environment and may allow us to exist in this environment. Okay, if there are no variations, what will happen? We may die or become extinct. Okay, so let me again, well, let us discuss more about these variations. So you can see this is a variation. I have just showed you the example over here. So this is a parent. The body structure is same for all the offsprings in different generation. Now this is the first generation. This is a second child. The body structure is similar. Whereas there is a way, if you take this is a head, these are the ears, and this is the other parts of the body or neck you can take it as. So here in the first generation, there is a variation. One of them will be getting a red color hair and one of them will be having a green color neck. Okay. Whereas in the second generation, there will be more lot of variation. One will be getting a red hair. One will be getting and also a white ear. Whereas one will be getting a red hair and a pink ear. Here some completely the color of the individual has changed into light blue color. And here the same variation has been continued. Means as the generations go on, the variations get accumulated. And when the variation get accumulated, totally we get a new species. Okay, so only we have been able to generate ourselves. Our ancestors are nothing but chimpanzees. So slowly these variations got accumulated and we have generated as a human beings. So here also you can see the giraffe. So original giraffe is usually yellow and white patches. Slowly we got a new one, that is the brown color, which is not usually commonly existent. Okay, now also we got a white one. So these are the variations. So as the variations get accumulated, we will be able to generate a new species. This is called generation of new species is known as speciations. So it may take, in case of multicellular organisms, it may take millions of years to get a new species. Whereas in case of a unicellular organisms like a bacteria or anything, we usually get, in a very short time, we can get a new, these variations can get accumulated and we may lead to get a new species. How these variations are useful? Okay. So how these variations are used, all variations are not useful, for example. So what is the importance of this variations? All variations are not useful for example, we ourselves, let us take as an example. All variations are not useful, but some variations are very useful and they will be allow us to adapt to the environment, surrounding environment. These variations allow us to adapt. So only we will be able, we for example, we will be are able to sustain this tropical climate of our hot sun and our body is able to sustain and we are able to survive in the tropical climate. Okay, so we got adapted to this variation. Suddenly we will be kept in a temperate region. No, we cannot survive immediately because our body, the genes, variations we accumulated will help us to sustain in the tropical climate, that is under extra hot sun. In the same way, again, also we are able to sustain a tropical climate. Again, we cannot sustain the extreme tropical climate, that is the desert conditions. Okay. So the what is the importance of what I'm trying to say, y'all, is what is the importance of this variation is this variation, some of the variations allow us to adapt to our environmental conditions, surrounding environmental conditions like temperature, humidity, air, everything they will allow us to adapt so that we can be able to survive and fit into that environment. Only the fittest will be able to survive. Otherwise, the remaining organisms which cannot, will not be able to survive. So only the fittest can survive in that environment or in that niche. Niche is called as also a small space in the environment is called as niche. Will be able to survive and exist. Otherwise, if the variations does not come in accordance to the surrounding environment, we slowly will become extinct organisms. So that is the importance of the variations. Hope you got it.
Yes,
all
ma'am.
All of you are sleeping?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yes? Hope you understood?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am.
All of you have noted down everything?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? So with this, I will stop the class for today. So I've given you the terminologies for the heredity and evolution. And we have talked what is a variation, what is the importance of the variation, or why we require variations. Okay? We talked about it. So in the next class, we'll be talking about complete Mendelian's principles. Any doubts in this class? Once let me call the names, participants' names. Niranjan. Niranjan.
No doubts, ma'am.
Understood everything?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am. Akash. Can
you show the last slide 1 second.
Okay, 1 minute. Yeah, this is the last slide.
Ma'am, the one before this. 1 minute. Noted, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Where are the other people? Only 8 are there remaining left. Sandhya, Ovya.
Ma'am, I'm here, ma'am.
No, you have more understood everything?
Yes, ma'am.
Hamsini?
Yes, ma'am.
Amrita?
Yes, ma'am.
Akash?
Ma'am, one doubt, ma'am.
What?
Ma'am, in F1 generation subtopic, I have one doubt, ma'am. In that it is given that the subsequent generations will be called as F2, F3 and all, ma'am. How to find what our generation is, ma'am?
No, our generation is lot. Where we start is what we should take care of. Okay, if you start with your parents, you will be your F1 generation.
Yes.
If you start with your grandparents, you can become a F2 and go on subsequently. If you go further and further, our generations will be different.
Okay.
Which one we take first, if the cross, what from where we want to study, that's will then decide the generations.
Okay.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm closing this session. Hope all of you understood. Within a day or two, you'll be getting your papers. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
And